misogynistic lyrics removed from Taylor Swift's updated Speak Now album. Why? Why? I don't know if the purple eyeshadow gives it away, but I didn't have any purple tops, so eyeshadow was the best I could go with. But today we're listening to Speak Now, Taylor's version, and I'm so excited. The only top I do have that has purple on it is a Louis Tomlinson t-shirt, and I didn't really feel comfortable wearing a Louis Tomlinson t-shirt while listening to Taylor Swift. And I surprisingly don't have any Taylor Swift merch, so. But that's gonna change when I go to the Eras Tour next year. So originally I was just going to react to just the 6 songs from The Vault and not the rest of the album because I already know all the songs, but I figured, you know, there's a good possibility that Taylor changed the lyrics to Better Than Revenge, so I kind of want to get my reaction on camera to that. So we're actually going to do this in 2 parts. This part that you're watching now, which is just the normal album, and then part 2 will be all the tracks from The Vault. I also wanted to get my nails done purple today, but instead I spent money at JB Hi-Fi. Let's do a quick little haul before we get into this. So I didn't pre-order the vinyl from Taylor's website, and so instead I went to JB Hi-Fi today and I got the vinyl and the CD. I want to do a little unboxing. I want to see what all the pictures are inside. I want to see what's going on. So obviously we all know the album cover. I always get scared opening CDs. Oh, she's so pretty. This is the picture that's on the back of the CD. This is obviously the back of the lyric booklet. And this is the full dress. Oh my gosh, she's so pretty. Oh my gosh, she's just so pretty. She's just like a little purple ballerina. And now let's open the vinyl. Oh my gosh. Oh, I love her so much. Are you ready? Oh my gosh, that is stunning. I think this is the nicest vinyl I own. And I know it's going to be the same, but oh my gosh. Stunning. Oh, so stunning. Oh, it's 3. I didn't even realize it was 3. I thought it was just 2. Oh, this one's like even. This one reminds me of a bowling ball. Don't you reckon? Gives me bowling ball vibes. This is Next Day Annie, something I forgot to say in my intro, but I'm saying now. I'm a big Taylor Swift fan, right? But I really only listen from like Red onwards. Obviously I've listened to Speak Now, I've listened to Fearless, I've kind of listened to Taylor Swift debut album, but I haven't listened to Speak Now as much as like some other people have. If I'm not pointing out some like obvious changes in the songs, it's because I don't really know. But if there are obvious changes that I didn't realize, any lyric changes or anything like that, besides Better Than Revenge, comment them down below, because I want to know. I want to know what else was different. If there's anything else that I missed, please, please let me know. But please don't attack me in the comments for not knowing. Okay, I'm sorry. Anyways, with my little haul, my little unboxing out of the way, let's just get into listening to part 1. Of Speak Now Taylor's version, the original album portion of the Taylor's version album. I'm so excited. I've immediately added it to my library. First song, mine, Taylor's version. Oh my god!
This man's careful daughter, you are the best thing that's ever been mine. But it was hard to take, yes, yes, this is what I thought about. Do you remember we were sitting there by the water? You put your arm around me for the first time. Brace myself for the
Oh my gosh! That was mine, Taylor's version. Obviously, I've been listening to the album a lot recently since like it was announced that it's being released. So I was listening to like the original version and just the difference in her vocal control, like the deepness of her voice as well. Because obviously she was still like 19, 20 when she recorded the original Speak Now. So her voice hadn't like fully developed yet. And it's just like, oh my gosh, you've come so far. And I'm just... she just sounds so good. She sounds so good. Sparks Fly, Taylor's version. Oh, that already sounds different. Like the tone of the guitars is already slightly different. Already, like that intro, like that tiny little, like, I don't know, 10 seconds at the start, sounds very, very similar. But then the tone of that guitar, it sounds, I want to say deeper. I don't know. It sounds deeper. And I could wait patiently, but I really wish you would drop everything. I love that song so much. Back to December, Taylor's version. Taylor Lautner's version? Is this like his side of the story? How's life? Tell me, how's your family? I haven't seen them in a while. You gave me roses and I left them there to die.
And I'd go back to December, turn around and make it all right. And I'd go back to December all the time.
Ah! Ah! I accidentally skipped. Taylor, I'm so sorry. What were we up to?
So this is me standing in my pride, standing in front of you, saying I'm sorry for that night.
Another bridge. December, turn around and change my own mind. I don't think I'm ready for this bridge.
Back to December all the time. I miss your tan skin, your sweet smile, so good to me, so right. And when you held me in your arms that September night, the first time you ever saw me cry. Maybe this is wishful thinking, it's probably mindless dreaming. So if the chain is on your door, I understand. But this is me swallowing my pride, standing in front of you, saying I'm sorry for that night. And I'd go back to December. Turns out freedom ain't nothing but missing you, wishing I realized what I had when you were mine. And I'd go back to December, turn around and make it all right. And I'd go back to December all the time.
Taylor Lautner, I salute you, sir. You are truly one of a kind. Actually, two of a kind, because your wife's name is also Taylor Lautner. Speak now, Taylor's version.
I am not the kind of girl who should be rudely barging in on a white veil occasion. Don't say yes, run away now. I'll meet you when you're out of the church at the back door. Oh, and they said, speak now.
I will forever love the delivery of that line of pageant queen. She just sounds so good.
Down the, aisle like a pageant queen.
The harmonies on that line.
But I know you wish it was me. You wish it was me, don't you?
Gosh, the delivery on Peace sounds so much stronger than the original version. Wait. Because I feel like in the original song, it was more like breathy, like more in her head voice. I know the terms. This is like way more in her chest voice. One more time. I think it hurts more with her, like, her more mature voice.
Counting my footsteps, praying the floor won't fall through.
No, nothing can hurt more than the original.
Again, paint me a blue sky, then go back and turn it to red.
It's not your blame.
Maybe it's you and your sick need to give love then take it away.
It is. That's the reason. That's, you blame him.
Understand.
Oh, I hate him so much.
Should have known.
He should have known. Yes. Oh. John, you should have known. He should have known. I don't think that song will ever get any easier to listen to. Me.
Words like knives and swords and weapons that you use against me. You have knocked me off my feet again. Got me feeling like a nothing. You
can take me down with just one single blow.
But you don't know what but you don't know. Someday I'll be living in a big old city, and all you're ever gonna be is me.
Oh, I gotta be so mean.
All you are is me. All you are is me. And a liar, and pathetic, and a lonely life, and mean, and mean, and mean, and mean.
Yeah!
Someday I'll be big enough so you can hear me, and all you're ever gonna be is mean.
Why you gotta be so mean?
Oh, that song always slays! The Story of Us, Taylor's version.
So many things that I wish you knew. So many walls up I can't break through. Now I'm standing alone in a crowded room, and the night is speaking. I don't know what to say since the twist of fate when it all broke down. And the story of us looks a lot like a tragedy now.
Next chapter.
Pulling at my clothes and trying to look. I almost choked on my straw.
I tell you I miss you, but I don't know how. I've never heard silence quite this loud. Now I'm standing alone in a crowded room, and we're not speaking. And I'm dying to know, is it killing you like it's killing me?
Deeper. I just think that's like the one thing that's always just gonna keep throwing me off. I'm like, oh, expecting it to sound like 19-year-old, 20-year-old Taylor when
and it's 32-year-old Taylor.
32 and 19. Never grow up. Taylor's version.
Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. It could stay this simple. Nothing's ever left you scarred. And even though you want to, just try to never grow up.
Like the fact that she wrote this at 18, 19, like talking to her 14-year-old self, that much has happened in that little time. So I'm sure re-recording this song probably would have been a bit emotional. You know, no one wants to get old. And I'm sure that during the re-recording of this song, she's probably just kind of, you know, looking back at her life, looking at everything that she has accomplished so far, all that crap she went through, like 2015, 2016, 2017, all that drama. And she's probably just like, whoa. Wasn't expecting that when I was 19. Like, she thought she'd already been through it. I'm sure re-recording this song was very emotional.
Ooh, I don't wanna grow up. Wish I'd never grown up. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever grow up. Could stay this simple. Just never grow up.
Enchanted. My favorite Speak Now song.
There I was again tonight.
That was so deep. Wait.
There I was again tonight.
One more time.
There I was again tonight. Forcing laughter, faking smiles. Your eyes whispered, have we met? Across the room, your silhouette starts to make its way to me. All I can say is I was enchanted.
Oh, the
bass.
Oh. someone else. Please don't have somebody waiting on you. Somebody waiting on you. Whoa. Literally, I just love that song so freaking much. And it's still just utter perfection. Now, the song we've all been waiting for. Literally, the song that made me go, no, I want to film my reaction in case she changed the words. Which apparently she has. Better than Revenge. Taylor's version.
Now go stand in the corner and think about what you did.
When it was hot and it was summer and she took him faster than you could say sabotage.
Whoa, wait. That was like a trap beat in the back. That sounded different. Let me listen.
She came along, got him alone, and let's hear the applause. She took him faster than you could say sabotage. I never saw it coming, wouldn't have suspected it. She's not a saint, she's not what you think.
Here it is. Here's the line. What's the lyric? Because on Spotify it's coming up as the same lyric. She's better known for the things she does on the mattress. What's the lyric? Wait.
He was a mark to the thing she was holding the matches.
He was a something. She was lured to something. She took away the line.
Soon she's gonna find stealing other people's toys on the playground while making many friends. She should keep in mind, she should keep in mind.
Wait, I have to find out what that line is.
He was a mob to the flame, she was holding the matches. Whoa. Soon she's gonna find stealing other people's toys on the playground while making many friends. You might have him, but I always get the last few. She's not a saint and she's not.
All right. I have no idea what she's saying.
Do you still feel like you know what you're doing? Cause I don't think you do. She took him faster than you could say sabotage.
Because on Google it just says it's the same lyric, but it's not. Wait, the lyric video. And she's not what you think, she's an actress. Whoa.
He was a moth to the flame, she was holding the matches.
He was a moth to the flame, she was holding the matches. It just doesn't have the same. Oh! He was a moth to the flame, she was holding the matches. But mattress just rhymes so much better with actress. Anyways, innocent.
I guess you really did it this time. You're still an innocent.
If you can't tell, this isn't a song that I listen to regularly. So I clearly don't know the words to this song.
You can't speak of.
He's definitely done some more things.
Okay, life is a tough crowd. 32 and still growing up now.
Why was everyone 32?
It's not what you did.
That's a cursed age.
You're still an innocent. Ooh, lights change like the weather. I hope you.
This song, hopefully, at some point has been used on all the Hunger Games edits. This song should be used on every Hunger Games edit.
It's never too late to get it back.
She's too nice. Taylor Swift, girl, I don't get how you can forgive so easily. I personally would not have, but I hold grudges, so it's fine. No, I didn't just decide to, you know, change my outfit, change my hair, you know, redo my makeup. It is currently the next day. My camera battery decided just to absolutely cark it last night and it died. So it's now the next day. But let's just get straight back into it. All right, we are now up to Haunted, Taylor's version. It sounds different. You and I walk a fragile line. I have known it all this time, but I never thought I'd live to see it break. Wow, it sounds so different. It's getting dark and it's all so quiet. Something's made your eyes go cold. Come on, don't leave me like this. I thought I had you figured out. Turn back, now I'm haunted. I feel like this song doesn't have like the same impact now that her voice is more mature. I think this song, and also Better Than Revenge, needed like the younger, less mature voice to kind of give it that impact, give it that anger, give it, you know, all that, like the feeling behind the songs. So I don't know if it's just her vocals that are making this song kind of have a different feel, or if it's she's kind of changed the instrumentation a little bit. I don't know, but it's just, it's not as, I don't think it's as powerful as it was. The voice crack. Oh my god. That sounds so cool. Last Kiss. Okay, again, this isn't a song that I listen to a lot, so I don't know any of the words. Party, you're sewing off again, and not a role much for dancing, but for you. So I'll watch your life in pictures like. A very, very beautiful song, just one that I don't really listen to a lot because I'm more like listening to upbeat songs rather than slow songs. Folklore is literally my favorite album though. Anyways, Long Live, Taylor's version. I said, remember this moment in the back of my mind. Long live the walls we crashed through. The kingdom lights shine just for me and you. I was screaming, long live all the magic we made, and bring on all the pretenders. I'm not afraid. If you have children someday, when they point to the pictures, good, honestly. Okay, now that is the end of like the standard album, and there's two more songs from just like the regular album, not from the vault, from the deluxe version of the album, which I've actually never listened to, and it's for a really stupid reason. That reason is I hated the red dress. Red dress. Red dress on the album cover. I much preferred the purple. I literally never listened to the deluxe version because of the dress. I mean, I might have heard these songs, I actually have no idea. But this will most likely be just reaction to these songs as well. Owls, Taylor's version.
Don't you worry your pretty little mind. People throw rocks at things that shine and life makes love look hard. The stakes are high, the water's rough, but this love is ours.
Oh, that's so sweet. This is a very cute little song. It very much sounds like something a 19-year-old would write compared to all of her other things that she wrote at 19 and earlier. Wait, who is this about? Very cute little love song. And on to the last song for Speak Now, Taylor's version, just the regular part of the album, Superman. Oh, I thought it was gonna be a slower song.
Tall, dark, and Superman. He puts papers in his briefcase and drives away. I watch Superman.
She did not just rhyme singing with the reputation, and she actually made it sound like they rhymed. How is she that talented? I don't get it.
The one single word they say. I watch Superman fly away. You've got a busy day.
This song could so be on Hannah Montana. Oh my gosh, her ogles! I would never go over her ogles. So that was Speak Now, Taylor's version, just the regular album. So besides the absolute heartbreaking change in Better Than Revenge, lovely, lovely work on your re-recording there, Taylor. Someone pointed out on TikTok today, actually, or yesterday, that the new line in Better Than Revenge is such a folklore written line, and they were so right. Like, it's so much more mature. Like, it's a much more mature line than the original line, which was so iconic. But yeah, like, that's just crazy. Like, that's like folklore Taylor, which happened like 10 years later, which is just absolutely crazy. I also saw someone point out, and I think I said it last night, like, it's just some of the songs are just kind of missing, like, that impact, like, that punch that you get from listening to Speak Now. And I think it's seriously just because she's moved on from that portion of her life, so there's obviously not as much emotion being poured into these songs when she's re-recording them. Like Better Than Revenge, she's clearly moved on from that situation if she's besties with Sophie Turner and Joe Jonas. And then Back to December, if Taylor Lautner was just at her show and came on stage and said the most beautiful words about her ever. But yeah, I think it's just, you know, over time she moves on from things, and so there's not that emotional punch to these songs anymore, which I think is what a lot of people are like, oh, it just doesn't sound as good. She was 18, 19, 20 when she recorded Speak Now. You know, she was still a teenager, turning into like a young adult. She had a lot of anger in her, whereas I just don't think she has that anymore. So like, that's good for her. Bit annoying for us, but still good, still good. I'm literally gonna go straight in and record my reaction to the Vault tracks. If you wanna watch that video, go find it on my page. It'll be up soon. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.